is it here on the head?
Yep, that's it. And here are a lot of infections on the leaves.
And up on the flag leaf.
Yep. Here's a leaf that's heavily affected.
And just about completely killed.
Here we're looking for Stagonospora Nodorum Blotch. This is a fungal disease of wheat that's also called septoria, or leaf and glume blotch. And I'll call it SNB for Stagonospora Nodorum Blotch. This disease starts in the lower wheat canopy. Either it comes from the seed being infected, so it can be seed-borne, or from spores that fall onto the wheat from the air or splash onto the wheat from debris that's on the ground. And once it gets started in the lower wheat canopy, then the way it climbs up the canopy is from rain splash. So if it's rainy, the fungus will ooze its spores. The spores will get splashed onto a higher leaf layer. And as the wheat gets taller, the fungus will travel up the canopy with the wheat if there's splashy rain. Stagonospora really is encouraged by wet, rainy conditions. It likes warm weather too. So once it's on the plant, warm, wet weather will cause rapid escalation of the disease. Usually we'll see SNB, or leaf and glume blotch, early in the season a little bit. In almost every wheat field there'll be a little bit. What we have to watch out for is when it really gets going in the mid canopy. And our main goal is to protect the flag leaf and the leaf right below the flag leaf. So we need to watch that we don't get flag leaf infections, and if there's major disease development around heading, then it's important to spray a fungicide in order to protect the flag leaf. It's important to protect the flag leaf because that supplies a major part of the nutrients, the photosynthate that goes to fill the grain in the wheat head. The flag and the flag minus one give the majority of that. Then the wheat heads themselves, the glumes and the awns, those hair-like structures on the glumes, also supply important nutrients for grain fill. We want to protect the flag leaf because we don't want lesions of the fungus there that can splash spores onto the heads and get those heads infected, because that's where losses to test weight and yield might come in. We're not sure how dramatic those losses are. That's something we're trying to measure right now. We think it may have more of an effect on test weight, so it will lower that grain density more than seriously affect the yield. In any case, if it does infect the kernels of wheat, then we know it can be transmitted to the crop the following season. So it can be a seed-borne disease. SNB, or leaf and glume blotch, starts out with these small dark brown to black dots. They look like dark chocolate. Those dots will expand to look first like that, and then as they grow and expand, more like these larger lesions here, they'll assume a kind of coffee brown color. And oftentimes there'll be yellow circles around them, or halos, which we call chlorosis. Now, this is a leaf that's very typical of the way that SNB develops and expands. And you can see how some of the lesions are still very tiny and others have expanded and developed a yellow halo around them. That's very typical. Also, in the middle of the larger lesions, we can start to see very tiny black dots, which are the fruiting bodies where the fungus makes spores. And in rain, those ooze out onto the leaf surface and can be splashed onto other leaves. These lesions are typically brown to black to purple. They can be a little different on different wheat varieties. What makes them different from head scab is that they are darker colored, and they tend to be kind of all over the head, as opposed to head scab, which will bleach out one certain section of the head. And that bleaching will be a lighter color. If you need to spray for Stagonospora because you've got a lot of infections in the mid canopy and you're trying to protect your flag leaf and your F-1, the strobilurin fungicides, or mixtures of triazoles and strobilurins, are highly effective. The only thing you have to think about is that if you apply a strobilurin fungicide close to flowering and you have high risk for head scab, a different disease, then the strobilurin could actually aggravate your head scab problem. So you have to pay attention to your scab risk when you're deciding what fungicide to put on for SNB control, for septoria control. More information about SNB or leaf and glume blotch can be found at the North Carolina Small Grains Production website. There are pictures of the disease and also guidance about fungicide application. And if you're not sure you have a problem with it, you should send whole plants, including the roots, in moist soil to the Plant Disease and Insect Clinic of NC State University, and it can be diagnosed, and we can tell you if, in fact, you are looking at SNB or some other problem.
This program is funded by the North Carolina Small Grain Growers Association.